The U.S. Air Force, USAF, drop-tested the Raytheon-made Stormbreaker munition from an F-35 fighter for the first time this year. Raytheon added that the late 2021 test was conducted as part of the Smart Munitions integration process with the fifth-generation aircraft. As for the F-35, it will be able to carry 8 Stormbreaker weapons internally and 8 externally, providing the 5th-gen aircraft with the capability to hit moving targets in adverse weather, addressing a wide range of threats and scenarios. Further versatility is added by the multi-effects warhead, which is equipped with shaped charge jets, fragmentation and blast charge effects, and an option for a delayed smart fuse. The total weight of the weapon is just over 200 pounds, with half of it being the warhead alone. Previously known as the Small Diameter Bomb 2, is an American air-launched, precision-guided glide bomb. The 25-year Stormbreaker development process began in 2006, when the USAF awarded Raytheon $144 million for risk reduction work on the munition as part of the Small Diameter Bomb Increment 2 program for a 250-pounds, 113-kilograms, class bomb that can identify and strike mobile targets from standoff distances in all weather conditions. It will be integrated on the McDonnell Douglas F-15E Strike Eagle, F/A-18 Hornet and F-35 Lightning fighters. The work took 3 years, and in 2010, the Air Force awarded Raytheon a $450 million engineering, manufacturing, and development Stormbreaker contract. In 2019, the USAF awarded Raytheon a $200 million life cycle support contract, including integration, production, and sustainment of the Stormbreaker until 2024. According to Raytheon, the munition uses a tri-mode seeker, which includes imaging infrared and millimeter wave radar, to see through fog, smoke and rain to glide over 45 miles, 72 kilometers, and strike at a fixed or moving target on land or at sea. Raytheon claims that the munition, packed with shaped charge jets, fragmentation and blast charge effects, can destroy a tank. The weapon is capable of fusing the information from the sensors to classify the target and can prioritize certain types of targets as desired when used in semi-autonomous mode. Moreover, the weapon can also be launched from one platform and controlled from another. That will be an important capability as the US military aims to connect sensors, platforms and weapon systems across the traditional domains of land, air, sea and space.